The author, Ralph Ellison, was a major advocate for the African-American advancement. During the time the novel was written in the 1930s, society was experiencing violent racial prejudices and African-American oppression.
The narrator is never given a name throughout the story, endorsing his invisibility. The narrator sees himself as invisible because people refuse to see who he is beneath harsh stereotypes. Through his traumatic experiences, however, he sheds this blindness and comes to terms with his struggles. At the beginning of the novel, the narrator has gone underground with his many light bulbs because he's given up on society.
Jim Trueblood is an uneducated, poor black man that lives outside of the black college. His story of impregnating his own daughter brings a surprising amount of attention from the white community. The white population's new interest in Trueblood demonstrates their tendency to link nothing but negativity to blacks.
Brother Jack is the white and unconditionally loyal leader of the Brotherhood, a political organization that claims to support the rights of the socially oppressed. Although he initially seems kind and dedicated to the goals of the Brotherhood, Jack eventually reveals his racist viewpoints and is unable to see people as anything other than tools.
Ras the Exhorter is the angry black nationalist that often turns to violence to overthrow white supremacy. Ras frequently disagrees with the Brotherhood and the narrator and instigates a large riot in Harlem.
All after bed, spring's heart has led, feel like old Ned, wish I was dead.
Racism preventing individual identity is a major theme of the novel. As the narrator passes through a variety of communities, he finds each endorses a different idea of how blacks should act in society. His attempts to define himself through the expectations of others prevent him from establishing individuality, eventually forcing him underground.
Another prominent theme is the destructiveness of fighting stereotypes with stereotypes. Each black community the narrator encounters expresses a different idea of how blacks should behave. The narrator finds that by limiting themselves to strictly their race, they only bring about increased oppression and counterproductivity.
Blindness is a key symbol throughout the novel. Blindness is demonstrated by both whites and blacks. People tend to avoid seeing and confronting the truth by refusing to see what they wish not to see. This is represented through Brother Jack's glass eye and the ambiguity of who our narrator is.
Ain't got a friend. My only sin is in my skin.